Everybody, and first up tonight, the City of Pueblo moving forward with a plan to provide a short-term warming shelter to the homeless. Now, the work begins to sort out the details and get it up and running.
That includes the big questions like who will staff the site, how they plan to secure it, and when will it open?
News 5's Sam Kramer gathering more details in our continuing coverage at 10. Sam.
Yeah, Councilman Mark Aliff tells me the Pueblo Rescue Mission will be staffing the shelter in the parking lot of the old Wayside Cross Rescue Mission building on 4th Street. Now, they have valuable experience in working with the homeless, including learning from last year's mistakes, but also sorting out paperwork as the operator may delay the shelter's opening.
It's not a perfect solution.
Well, I feel good about the fact that we're going to get people off the streets in this cold, cold weather and get them in somewhere warm.
But it's good enough for the next few months. Pueblo's warming shelter will sit here with two big tents, heaters, and porta potties, despite the wishes of neighbors like Lee Gladney, whose family has operated Pueblo Bearing Services for nearly 70 years.
I think we're just really opening rolling out a red carpet for the homeless to come to downtown Pueblo. I'm not saying that we don't need to help these people, but placing it in downtown Pueblo is not the place to put it.
Councilman Mark Aliff, who's led the charge on addressing homelessness, doesn't see that as an issue.
I don't think that 5 months at that location is going to create any enormous problems that is going to cause anybody very much grief at all.
Here's why. Each tent will have two private security workers at night, in addition to one at the site during the day. On top of that, the operator announced Tuesday as the Pueblo Rescue Mission has experience in this field of work.
We cannot do this without staff and people that have worked with the homeless in the past.
And for a city that's endured a handful of squatter set fires and abandoned homes, Aliff says he believes staff and security will be enough to protect the homeless from the risk of fires associated with propane heaters.
We'll work very closely with our fire department and make sure that everything's safe. I mean, we obviously wouldn't open it up if we felt that there was going to be a problem with safety.
Aliff says it's now likely the shelter will open in 10 to 14 days, giving the mission enough time to hire staff. While no physical or mental health resources will be provided, the city is looking at also contracting a modified semi-truck to give people access to the showers. The mission's board of directors will meet tomorrow, which will also help determine how families will be cared for. Always watching out for you, Pueblo, I'm Sam Kramer, News 5.